The Appalachian Wireless 30th Anniversary Holiday Sale is going on now. From now until the end of the year, visit us in store or reserve online for an unbelievable sale and giveaway. We know what you want for the holidays because we are you. We are Appalachian Wireless.
Fire safety is always very important, but especially so during the holiday season. With lots of food, decorations, and distractions at every corner, it can be difficult to keep an eye on what's really important when you're in the middle of all that action. To that end, we caught up with Pikeville City Fire Department's Public Information Officer, Nick Fleming, for some tips and strategies on how to keep yourself and your family safe this holiday season.
Yeah, so we're here today to talk a little bit about fire safety in the home, particularly around Thanksgiving. Just a little fun fact, during Thanksgiving, there's three times as many kitchen incidences or fires, so we want to prevent that as best we can. So just some hints and tips on that is try not to leave any food unattended at any time, so try to keep an eye on it. I know things take a little bit longer during the holidays to cook, turkeys, hams, things like that, so try to make sure to keep an eye on it. Set timers to remind yourself when to check on it, particularly.
Along with these general tips, Fleming also had some more specific advice regarding one notoriously risky way that some may choose to prepare their Thanksgiving centerpiece.
So let's talk a little bit about deep fryer safety, particularly when we're talking about deep frying our turkeys. So we want to thoroughly make sure that our turkeys are thawed out and are at room temperature, because if you put a frozen turkey in there, it's going to cause a big flash fire. We do not want that. Make sure you don't use too much oil. Make sure you use the correct amount of oil, and we want to slowly lower our turkeys into the fryer. So use a utensil. A lot of times we have like a spatula or a hook that comes with the fryer. We can use that to lower the turkey in there slowly. And again, just like anything else, keep an eye on it. With any of our cooking, we want to have a Class A, B, C extinguisher available. It's like a dry chemical extinguisher nearby, just in case a fire was to erupt, especially with our deep fryers. And if you have any questions about any of your extinguishers that you may need or what type to get, just come by the fire station. We'll be more than happy to help you.
When asked if their station receives more calls regarding house fire incidents during the holidays, Fleming said they do, but noted an increase in medical emergencies that also occur as a result of these incidents.
We do, and like I said, it's three times more likely to have a fire in the kitchen due to the fact that people don't take these precautions, and they'll not only start a fire, but they'll get burnt or injured, so you know we'll have to respond in a medical emergency as well. So we want to try to prevent that, and hopefully these tips will help you out with that.
For Mountaintop News, I'm Joshua Sloan.